Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking about lip augmentation and particularly how to create a beautiful lip shape without overdoing the lip or adding too much volume. This is a common question we get. First of all, talking about lips, it's really important to mention that social media has increased the number of lip injections we do, and there's so much interest created by selfies, by Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, and this channel, that it's one of the most common requested fillers and filler applications we get. And it's also the most difficult area to fill because the mouth is always dynamic. So we're trying to create a pretty shape, and the nerve fibers in the lip area and around the mouth are sensitive. So we'll talk a little bit about pain control. So there's three pillows in the lip. There's three in the top, if you include the center tubercle, and there's two in the bottom. And then there's the vermilion border, the area where the pink meets the white, and then there's the vertical lip lines. Those are the most commonly addressed and talked about. However, today I want to show you how to address the center and that center tubercle in the middle of the lip, and also the Cupid's bow. The Cupid's bow can create the illusion of less distance between the upper lip and the nose, or this ergotrid area. And that's important, especially as people get older, but also our younger millennial patients, they are very attuned to angles and the golden ratio, the phi numer, 1.6, 1 to 1. So we're always trying to create those and understand that the philtrum columns go in an angle. They're not straight up and down, and they're not splayed laterally. So what I do is I dress the border of the lip first, then I address the body, depending if there's vertical lip lines or the patient is describing lipstick bleeding into the lips, which is common, even starting at a younger age like 30 plus. And then we address the center of the Cupid's bow. Now here, I like to use a vibratory anesthetic device along with the topical. As we move towards the center of the lip, it's more and more sensitive because those sensory nerve fibers converge. And we fill the philtrum column. We create an illusion of the shortening distance, but also a very pretty look, especially when we couple it with filling the tubercle, or that center part of the lip that people always forget to fill. It's important sometimes to ask the patient before you fill this area if they like it or don't like it. Most of our patients will say, "I don't know, what do you think?" So give them your opinion. Your artistic flair and your experience in filling this area is key, because a lot of times it's not talked about or addressed. So use a vibratory anesthetic device in that area, address the central portion, fill the philtrum columns, reduce the distance of that ergotrid if necessary for the patient. The lip is fun to fill, it's dynamic, it moves, so it can be complicated. It's important to take pictures not only of the patient at rest, but also with movement before and after filling. So join me on this YouTube channel, subscribe, join our family, send me some comments in the space below, tell me your experience with lip fillers and how you like to fill them, and continue to watch us for helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.